Hey guys, this is Austin, and today I'm here with part 3 of my computer build tutorial. The last two videos have gone over how to install everything in the case, but now it's time to hook it all up and finish the computer. Time for the really fun part, wiring. I'm actually lying, wiring is no fun at all. However, as long as you think a bit about how everything connects, it's really not all that bad. First step is to grab the pair of SATA cables that came with the motherboard. Plug both of these into the connectors on the bottom right of the board. Grab one and run it up to your hard drive. As you can see, they're notched, so they can only go in one way. Simply press it in until it clicks. Now do the same with the other cable for the DVD drive. Now you should see some cables attached to the case. Grab the one labeled HDA, which is your front panel audio. There is a single pin knocked out, so you can only plug it in one way. On this motherboard, it's in an awkward spot between the graphics card and the audio connectors. However, with a bit of work, it will fit. You'll also see your front panel USB. This works the same way, except that thankfully this is much easier to install. Just plug it into the USB connector on the bottom of the board and you're good. You'll also see a small bundle of umbilical cables for the power button and LEDs. These need to be plugged into the front panel connectors beside the SATA ports. If you look closely, you'll be able to see that where each cable goes is marked on this tiny pinout. However, if you look at your motherboard manual, you'll see it recreated a bit better. The most important thing is to note the positive and negative sides, as obviously plugging them in wrong won't work. I won't go over each and every cable, but once you get going it isn't that hard. Once you're done, it should look a little something like this. Not the neatest thing in the world, but it works. Move over to the heatsink and unwind the power cable. This is a 4-pin connector with a pair of notches to make sure you plug it in correctly. Find the CPU fan connector on your motherboard and plug it in. Covering up the camera with your arm is totally optional, of course. Let's continue connecting fans. The Antec 300 has a pair of fans, and both of them have the same type of connector, except as a 3-pin. You'll find another system fan header on the bottom left of this motherboard to hook up the exhaust. Unfortunately, this motherboard doesn't have another connector, so we're going to have to come back for the third fan. Now come down to the power supply, unwrap the cables, and pull them out of the case. Before we get into connecting everything, let's go over what cables do what. The biggest connector is your 20-pin motherboard power cable. This is what powers everything on the motherboard, and it also uses an additional 4-pin connector. You'll also find a 6-pin cable. This is generally for powering graphics cards, and depending on the power supply, will sometimes have an additional 2 pins for higher powered cards. Moving on, you'll see these larger connectors, which are known as Molex. We really won't be using these in our build, however they can be useful for using with adapters, which we will be doing. You'll also see a pair of 4-pin connectors. These are for CPU power and also connect to the motherboard. Lastly, we have these long flat cables, which are SATA power. This is what we'll be using to power our hard drive and optical drive. I know this is a lot to go over, but it's really pretty simple. The first thing is to plug in the 20 plus 4-pin motherboard power connector. It's best to route this behind the motherboard tray, but the cable is a bit short on this power supply, so just push it all the way back. Once the main cable is connected, plug in the additional 4-pin connector. Now you'll need to power the graphics card. The Radeon 7770 only needs a single 6-pin connector, so press it in until it clicks. For the hard drive and DVD drive, you'll need to grab a pair of SATA power cables and plug in the hard drive on bottom and then the DVD up top. Again, depending on the power supply and case, it's usually best to run these behind the tray and then back out to make sure everything is as neat as possible, but here we just need to stretch everything to fit. Since the power supply is unraveled, we can now connect the last fan. I had a 3-pin to Molex adapter lying around, which will work perfect. Just connect the male and female Molex ends together, and then connect the fan to the 3-pin connector and you're good to go. Last but not least, we've got to connect the CPU power, which are the pair of 4-pin connectors. This motherboard only uses one, so locate it up at the top left of the board and click it into place. Amazingly enough, we're almost there. All our parts are installed and everything is wired up. It looks like a minor computer explosion now, but we'll clean up our wiring in a minute. Grab the large AC power connector and plug the power supply into the wall. Then grab a monitor and keyboard and connect everything together. Now is the scariest part of the entire build, seeing if it actually works. Hit the power button and give it a go. If it boots, give yourself a high five, you did it. If not, don't worry too much, usually it doesn't work first try. Go back and double check all of your connections and make sure the power supply is switched on. Once it does turn on and get into the BIOS, take a look at the build. Are all the fans running? How about on the graphics card? Check the power supply as well. If all is good there, go into the BIOS and take a look around. It should detect your CPU and installed memory, and your hard drive and DVD drive should show up as well. If everything looks good, you're almost there. We're not quite done yet though, the inside is still a bit of a mess. Cable management is an important part of the build to make future upgrades easier, improving airflow, as well as just making the build look better. I won't show every step along the way, but the basic idea is to group cables as neatly as possible and use electrical ties to hold them together. I didn't do a great job here, but considering how short the power supply cables are, it's good enough and a major improvement. Now put the side panels back on, screw them in with your thumb screws, and you're all done. Congratulations, you've built a gaming computer. If you guys enjoyed this tutorial and found it helpful, I'd really appreciate it if you could leave a thumbs up. If you want to check out this exact build, I'll have a link on screen now, and I'll also be doing a giveaway of this PC soon, so be sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss it or any of my other computer build videos. Hopefully you enjoyed this tutorial, and since you made it all the way to the end, thanks for watching.